Andy Johnson, Minnesota State University. We are looking at repeated reading, a type of fluency activity. It improves students' ability to recognize words and process letters through reoccurring practice of the same text. It's like doing musical scales or practicing any athletic skill. You do it, you practice time and time again, so you can do it without thinking. Automaticity. It comes in a variety of forms. I would encourage you to adopt and adapt and see which one works best for you and your students. The simplest and most basic is words per minute. You give students a graded text at their instructional level, or you may want to experiment with independent level at first. Remember, we don't want to frustrate students. On command, you say go, and students read for 1 minute to see how many words they can read in 1 minute. Mark off every 10 words or create number marks in the margin to make it easier to count, 10, 11, 12, 13, etc. when you stop. And the goal is to read as many words. Don't worry about miscues or errors. There are other places to look at and assess word identification errors. We'll be looking at that in just a minute. It's a positive way for students to see growth. You should do it 3 times. And again, they can see their words getting better each time. Students then record their times on some sort of graph. I like the line graph like this. It should take between 5 and no more than 8 minutes, but I find it's usually between 3 and 5 minutes, daily fluency activities. Students keep track or document their own growth. Again, positive way, they can keep track in their own portfolios. Students keeping track, again, I like a line graph of some sort, but you can do it any sort of way that you want. Words correct per minute, all right? It can be used to document progress, but for daily fluency, see, I do not recommend this. As I've shown in other videos, there are other ways, more appropriate ways, to assess word identification. This is just fluency. We get all mixed up when we try to combine comprehension and fluency and word identification. They're 3 separate things. Not all students need focus on each element. 30 words fluency, 40 word fluency, 50 word fluency. All right, for students at the emergent level, sometimes reading for 1 minute can be overwhelming. So a strategy I use is to break a story into 30, 40, or 50 word segments. And you have to use a little creativity to get exactly 30 words or exactly 40 words. Read each segment through 3 times, and again, they can see their times getting faster. Each segment should take students less than 30 seconds. If you're doing more than that, then you need to go down to the next level. If students are consistently able to read 12 seconds or less, then you need to go up to the next level. And I find it easier to take a real book, break it into 30-word segments. You use a lot of repetition. You have to do your own editing. Each one should make sense by itself. All right, so every day they have the context of a complete story that they're coming back to. And again, graph your results like that. A second or another one is reread to make meet goal. You start by finding their approximate words per minute at the independent reading level, and then you set a goal just slightly ahead. If they're reading 55 words per minute, set the goal at 60, and you record the number of attempts it takes them to get that goal. The goal is 65 words per minute. It took them 5 times on this day, 3 times on that day, all right? And again, it's a positive way to show growth. Do not frustrate your students. Replay analysis. This one works great. Find a 25 to 40 word sample of text at their instructional level. Photocopy it and give one to the students. They audio record as they are reading the selection. Then they listen. They replay and they analyze, looking for miscues or stumbles. They circle the problem words. They reread until fluency is achieved. You can do this in partners. A teacher does not need to be there once you teach students how to do this. Replay analysis, that one works really good. All right, just some very simple repeated reading activities.